Hello and welcome everyone. This is part two of our SAP integration series. In the first part, we talked about SAP data integration challenges, a specific business use case, and a quick overview of Azure Synapse. Today, we are going to do a deep dive into our business use case, which is the sales dashboard report, and what are the prerequisites to build this report. This report shows you a summary of key sales information. For the source system, we are using SAP S/4HANA 2020, and the information that we are gathering is balance per year and selling journal and admin as percentage of sales from the universal journal table. Top 10 customers by revenue, top 10 materials sold by volume from some of the other tables like VBRK and VBRP. Once we have this data available, extracted, this lands into Azure Synapse. Effectively, we are storing this data in Azure Data Lake. Once the data is available in the raw format in Azure Data Lake, we apply ETL or ELT transformations within Azure Synapse Analytics using Synapse Data Mapping Flows, Synapse Spark, and SQL notebooks, using both dedicated SQL pools and serverless SQL pools. Upon transforming this data can be stored in dedicated SQL pools, which acts as a serving layer for the reporting mechanism. We have also performed advanced analytics, such as predictive modeling, using Azure Machine Learning. And then we have generated the final reports using Power BI, which is natively integrated into Azure Synapse. With that, I will hand it over to Mahesh, who is going to walk you through the architecture of this project. Thank you.
This slide shows the end-to-end architecture for the SAP and Azure Synapse Analytics integration. In the left-hand side, you can see SAP is installed in an Azure customer subscription, or it can also be installed in an on-premises network or other cloud platforms such as AWS. In order for Azure Synapse Analytics to connect to SAP and ingest the data into Azure Data Lake Storage, you need to install SHIR, stands for Self-Hosted Integration Runtime, which is a runtime which you can install in either physical or virtual machines. In this case, as SAP is installed in the Azure cloud, SHIR can connect to SAP using the VNet peering, virtual network peering, allowing the data to be transferred securely from within the Microsoft backbone network. Now, Azure Synapse Analytics can be configured to connect to SHIR. The first step is to move the data either as a one-off data movement or periodically on a scheduled intervals using the Azure Synapse pipelines, using the copy activity. Once the data is moved and stored into the Azure Data Lake Storage, you can then perform transformations using the mapping data flows within Azure Synapse Analytics. Also, you can use SQL scripts, which include both dedicated SQL pools, which is previously known as SQL Data Warehouse, and serverless SQL pools, allowing you to query the data in the Azure Data Lake Storage using TSQL interface. For the complex transformational scenarios, you may want to use something like Synapse Spark, which is open source Apache Spark, which also gives you good compatibility with your on-premises big data clusters. For performing advanced analytics such as machine learning, you can easily integrate with the Azure Machine Learning. Azure Synapse Analytics can take advantage of all the richness offered by the Azure Machine Learning in terms of AutoML, Responsible ML, MLOps, Visual Designer, etc. Also, you can use the pre-built models, are known as Azure Cognitive Services, such as Anomaly Detection, Text Sentiment Analytics, out of the box without worrying about the complexity in developing those ML models. Finally, we will use the Power BI, which is natively available within Azure Synapse Analytics, to create and publish the dashboards and reports into Power BI service. The architecture is greatly simplified, as Azure Synapse Analytics will alone handle almost all your data workloads. With that, I will hand it over to Pankaj to walk you through the environment settings for this project.
Thanks, Mahesh, for the architecture overview. After the architecture, let's have a look at the environment setup. We are effectively using three main components. The first is the source system, which is S4HANA 2020. The second is self-hosted integration runtime installed on a VM. And the third is Azure Synapse Workspace. The integration runtime is the compute infrastructure that Azure Synapse uses to provide data integration capabilities across different virtual network environments. It can run copy activities between a data store in cloud and a data store in an on-prem network. It can also dispatch transform activities against compute resources in an on-prem network or in an Azure virtual network. The installation is really simple. When you log into your Azure Synapse Workspace and you are defining your integration pipelines, you will create a link service. Here, you would select SAP Table Connector. And on the next screen, what you see is all the details for connecting to your SAP system, along with the details for integration runtime installation. You would install this in a small VM, and this particular VM could be placed in the same virtual network where you have your SAP systems, or it could be a different virtual network. If it's a different virtual network, ensure you have the communication available between these two different virtual networks, ensuring the integration runtime can communicate with your SAP systems. With that, I will hand it over to Mahesh for the summary.
So, to summarize, in this session, you have understood SAP source system details, the overview of the tables and the reports, which we have generated as part of this integration project. We have also did a deep dive into the architecture and the environment details of this project. In the next session, we will understand how to ingest the data from SAP into Azure Data Lake Storage using Synapse pipelines with its copy activity. And we'll review the use of mapping data flows to perform data transformations such as aggregations, filters, etc. Thanks for joining this session, folks. See you all in the next session. Thank you.